as we gather.
Gather, may we glorify your name, knowing well that as our hearts begin to worship, we'll be blessed because we came.
As we gather,
we'll be blessed because we came.
Testing. Okay. The mic is working.
Good morning, dear faithful friends, brothers and sisters of Grace, United Methodist Church. Welcome to another experience of God's presence as we worship the Lord. We welcome you today. You are a blessing to us, and we likewise be a blessing to you. For those who did come for the first time, again, we welcome you. Please feel at home. And these are your brothers and sisters in the family of God. And you can see each other in our Zoom. God bless you. Today is what we call in the Christian calendar Ascension Sunday. And we don't have that much to add, but to again, hope and pray we will experience the presence of God through Christ, who was lifted up to the heaven, and still feel our connectedness as one body of Christ here in our worship. So let us pray. God will bless us today. And also a kind of reminder that next Sunday is Pentecost Sunday, the birthday of the church. It is the time when the Holy Spirit came down through the tongues of fire. And hope that with all these things that we are doing and experiencing in our midst, despite of discomforts and limitations we have, we can still be together in the spirit of loving and serving God. Again, thank you for being here. God loves you, and so do I. Let us continue in our worship, and let us respond with gathering words. Clap your hands, all you peoples. For God has ascended with shouts of triumph and trumpet fanfare. Together, our God is exalted on high, sovereign over all the nations and Lord of our lives. Let us worship together. Let's continue in praising God as we gather in this song, Hail the Day That Sees Him Rise.
Thank you. Let us pray together. Blessed are you, O God, creator of all that is and all that ever will be. You sent your holy child, Jesus, to heal us and bless us, to show us your love. After his suffering and death on the cross, he was still among us, proclaiming repentance and forgiveness of sins. Just as you sent the power of the Holy Spirit to those who first believed, fill us now with your power and grace, that we may become the hands and feet and heart and spirit of Christ. Amen.
Let us now be again in the moment of sharing as a community of faith, as brothers and sisters, as a family of God, to share our joys and concerns, and for praying for one another and praying for others, as we are being led by our very own, our dear Reverend June Cowley.
Good morning, everyone. Happy Ascension Sunday. And we are grateful to be together again virtually. And hopefully we will be able to worship in person soon. We welcome you to our Grace Virtual, Grace United Methodist Church virtual worship service today. And so it's time to share our blessings, how the Lord has blessed us and how the Lord has touched us this past week. And of course, we're invited to share our prayer requests and concerns as a faith community. So anyone who would like to share their blessings and their concerns, and if you would like to share, please unmute yourselves. And after sharing, please mute yourselves back on. Anyone?
I think Atinita was wanted to say something.
Oh yeah, please, Atinita, if you want to say something, please unmute yourself.
Unmute yourself, Atinita. Yeah, okay.
I can hear you. Yeah, I'm happy that my son Manny will start working tomorrow. Oh, after yeah. 1 year of not working. Wow. The hotel will open already. So tomorrow he will start working.
Wow. We praise the Lord for that good news. God is good.
All the time.
God is good indeed. Well, thank you for sharing that blessing, Atinita. And we congratulate Manny for being able to work again after not working for a year. And what a blessing that is. Thank you for sharing that. Any other blessings, prayer requests? In terms of blessings, I have a list of people here who are celebrating their birthdays this week. Happy birthday to Atinora, who will be celebrating her birthday on the 18th. Mm. And then to Mari Carr, who will be celebrating her birthday on the 21st. And to Nanang Training Gorozo, who will be celebrating her birthday on the 22nd. And to Ama and Ina, Mr. and Mrs. Baluyot, for their wedding anniversary on the 18th. What blessings are these from the Lord that he has given to these brothers and sisters of ours? So as we celebrate birthdays of these members of our faith community, let's come together as we offer blessings to them. Let us pray. Oh God, we thank you that we could acknowledge the birthdays of Atinora, of Maricar, Nanang Trining, and the anniversary of Ama and Ina. Thank you for all the blessings you've given them this past year. We pray that you continue to bless them, continue to journey with them even as they face this new year in their lives, that you nurture them, that you sustain them with your love and grace, and that you grant them good health and good life, abundant life, and that let them know that you are by their side, O God, always. And so we offer these, your children, to your care and to your love. And we also, of course, we also remember those who are celebrating their birthdays that are not on our list. Whoever they are, we pray that you bless them. And we also include in our prayers your blessing upon Manny as he starts working tomorrow. Be with him too, O God. So thank you for all these blessings. Lord, we offer this prayer to you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. Any other blessings, requests? It looks like we don't have anything anymore. Well, let's continue to pray for each other. We'll continue to pray for our community, our nation, as we transition, you know, from different stages of this pandemic to some to a new normal again. We continue to pray for countries that are affected by the pandemic continuously, like India, South America, the Philippines, and we continue to pray for peace and unity and tolerance among people. And we also continue to pray for Israel and Palestine, what's happening in the Middle East, which is really disturbing. And so we pray that that governments, that the Israeli government, as well as the governments of the world, particularly the United States, will come to resolution in resolving the conflict. And so we pray for all of these, and that God will intervene somehow and through our prayers. So let us conclude now our prayers today.
Pastor?
Yes.
Just a short note. Just being grateful that there are volunteers who are willing to be helping us in the reopening of our church, and they're aiming at hopefully this July. And just want to thank Sister Lillian Capulli, Sister Nora Marker, we have Sister Joyce Villoria, we have Eliza Ramos and Carla Pasalo and Ezra Cambe. And they are really into intentionally helping us so that this prayer and hope for us to come back here at church will be realized. And they're asking, surveys will be sent to each family this week in ways that they will be reached through text, through emails, and through letters, and then they will be following up with phones, telephones. And also, we are requesting that after the service, if you are willing, or you would like that our church will reopen, please make use of the feature that we have in the Zoom, the chat room, to write or share your comments. Thank you.
Thank you, Pastor Alex, for that announcement. Yeah, so we'll include that in our prayers, as well as and asking the Lord to help us transition again. This is such a transition that we have been thinking of, and now it might be happening on the first Sunday of July, and what an exciting day that is for us to be together in our worship. And I think I also want to mention that last Thursday, some of our folks again worked together in putting sandwiches for the San Francisco Night Ministry once again. So we are grateful for those who have volunteered, once again, whoever you are, to work together to provide food to our brothers and sisters who are having home insecurity or who are homeless. So thank you for all the work that you do for our ministry as a faith community. So let us now come to the Lord in our prayer, and let us pray. Gracious God, you have heard those prayer requests and celebrations and blessings that we have received from you this past week. Lord, we offer them to you once again, trusting that you listen to us, trusting that you respond to all these needs that we have shared, oh God, knowing that it is only you who could help us, and who it's only you who could give us the hope and the comfort to know that somehow you are still at work in the world today, and that you are still in control of what is happening in the world, and that you're still in control of our lives, of our plans for the future. And so all we can do now is once again to commit everything into your care, all those that we have mentioned in our prayer requests and concerns, as well as those blessings that we have shared. Oh God, we continue to pray for our faith community that even as we transition into worshiping together in person, that you please guide us, that you please guide those church members who are leading this endeavor and this effort for us to be able to do this according to your will, oh God. And so help us or teach us to continue to pray together for this endeavor, O Lord. And I pray for your blessing upon each one of us as a family, it's each family that is represented in this virtual worship today. Lord, please continue to dwell in our hearts as you dwell in our homes, and that you may continue to be part of our lives as families, and even in our relationships, oh God, please be part of our relationships with our loved ones, with friends, and even those that we know at work. And so we commit our families, our loved ones to you too, oh Lord. And we commit this coming week to you. We do not know what lies ahead of us. All we know is that you will continue to walk with us, oh God, and wherever you take us, we pray that you make us your blessings. We pray that you make us your instruments of bringing love, of bringing joy, of bringing reconciliation and peace to those places where there is conflict, where there is hatred, and where there is darkness, that your light may shine upon those places, oh God. So thank you, Lord, and please bless our worship service today. This we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, who taught us to pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you, everyone.
For that, let us be in one spirit as we respond with a song.
Hear our prayer,
With that, let us now hear the reading of the scripture through a video.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to Luke, chapter 24, reading from verse 44 to 53. Then Jesus said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures, and he said to them, "Thus it is written, that the Messiah is to suffer and to rise from the dead on the third day, and that repentance and forgiveness of sins is to be proclaimed in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. And see, I am sending upon you what my Father promised. So stay here in the city until you have been clothed with power from on high." Then he led them out as far as Bethany, and lifting up his hands, he blessed them. While he was blessing them, he withdrew from them and was carried up into heaven. And they worshipped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy, and they were continually in the temple blessing God. The Gospel of Christ.
May the Lord add his blessings upon the reading of his word. And before I share you the message, let us be in a moment of praising God as we listen to a song to be shared to us by the brothers and sisters of the Baluyot family.
Lifting you up in this holy place, you are God.
What a blessing to hear those messages through songs. And again, God is really good, and he continuously using this wonderful talent that this our brothers and sisters, Baluyut family, have. God bless you, and may you continue to have that spirit and bless others. I have a story that I would like to share that is circulating in the internet. I don't know if it is true or not, but it is something interesting and it caught me. I want to share it with you. Seems that a woman came home to find her husband in the kitchen, shaking frantically with what looked like a wire or a cable running from his waist toward the electric outlet in the wall, and intending to save from being electrocuted, she grabbed a piece of wood that was leaning by the back door and gave his husband a good whack, breaking his arm into two places. Well, it was a shame. He was not being electrocuted at all. He was merely listening to his new iPod. Well, what would you have done? You walk in the kitchen, and basically spouses, wives do work in the kitchen, and then think your husband is being there and doing other things. And here comes the wife thinking that he's being electrocuted. You cannot touch him for fear of being electrocuted yourself. So the wife grabbed a board and hit him. How was she to know that he was just dancing to the music coming out of that tiny little headset? She had to make an instant decision, and who knows? Maybe he deserves one whack anyhow. Decisions. We are still faced with them, and so were the disciples. 40 days had passed since the resurrection. The disciples of Jesus have finally come to believe that he is alive, really alive. And the scriptures tell us that Jesus appeared to the disciples on several occasions. But it is now time for him to go back from where he came from, to heaven. And so once again, Jesus appears to disciples. He joins them in worship and announces to them that he will soon send the Holy Spirit to them. And when the Holy Spirit comes, they will be his witnesses in Jerusalem, in Judea, in Samaria, and even to the ends of the earth. And San Francisco is included. And after he has spoken these words to them, after he has given them the assurance of his presence, he is lifted up before them to heaven, literally, physically lifted up to heaven. What a conclusion to his ministry on earth. Before their eyes, Jesus ascends to heaven with a promise that the Holy Spirit will come upon them. Instead of Jesus being bodily present with them, they will become the body, his body. Instead of his words to guide them, they will speak his words for him. Instead of his physical presence, they will have his spirit and be his presence in the world. And with that spirit, they will truly experience Jesus promised. If you look in the Matthew chapter 28, the very last verse, it says, remember how that goes. We call it the Great Commission. Go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And lo, I am with you always, even until the end of the age. And at this, the disciples returned to Jerusalem. And once entered the city, they went back to where they had gathered. And our gospel reading tells us they were of one accord and devoted themselves in prayer. This is the very first picture of we have of the church of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is first mentioned of what the disciples did when Jesus was no longer with them. They were of one accord, and they devoted themselves to prayer. Imagine that impact to the disciples. They had seen Jesus physically ascend into heaven, and they were told they would be his witnesses. They would be his presence on earth. An author with the name Liz Higgs, and I would like to share you this her story, tells an amusing story of when her young daughter was baptized. Like many, after getting married, Liz had drifted away from the church. Even the birth of her daughter hadn't brought them back. And it was not until her mother's death and the ministry of the church at that time that she decided it was time for them to reconnect with God. Because she had not been baptized as an infant, her daughter was 4 when she was baptized. The pastor met with them and spoke about baptism, telling the little girl that in baptism, Jesus enters into our heart and lives with us. So the baptism ceremony went fine until after the service, as they gathered in the entry, in that exit door, the daughter seemed troubled and refused to talk. And her mom asked, "What's wrong, honey?" With a tight lips, she replied, "Nothing. I just had to keep my mouth closed so Jesus won't get out." Wow. "I just want to keep my mouth closed so that Jesus won't get out." She was worried that if she opened her mouth too wide, Jesus might escape. And yet the other way around is true, isn't it? In baptism, we receive the Holy Spirit. Jesus' presence comes within us, and we become his witnesses. Like the disciples at the Ascension, we are sent forth to be his voice. We are told to speak for him because we are connected to him. I don't know if you know Albert Einstein, the one who had a theory of relativity, the one who made the H-bomb. It is said that the wife of Albert Einstein was once asked if she understood her husband's theory of relativity. And she replied, "No, but I know my husband, and that's enough." The disciples knew Jesus. They knew that he could be trusted with their lives, and because they were connected to him, they were connected to God. The trust that has been built. When you and I, brothers and sisters, face difficulties and troubles in life, when the future looks dark and hopeless, we need something to hold on to. We need to be connected to God. And we are. The same Lord Jesus who welcomed the little children into his arms, the same Lord Jesus who healed the lepers and opened the eyes of the blind, the same Lord Jesus who offered himself up on the cross for our salvation, now sits at the right hand of God, the Father, and rules over all things. He can be trusted with all our days. He can be trusted and not worry about what the future brings. We can depend upon him to care for us. For Jesus rules over all, and he is the head of the church. Amen? And the disciples knew that. That's why they responded the way they did. Remember, our gospel tells us that when returned to Jerusalem, they were all of one accord. When you think about the diverse personalities that were part of that circle of disciples, that in itself is a minor miracle. They are in one accord. Even if they think differently, the disciples' hearts were bonded together by the resurrection. It is almost as if the experience of the cross had shown them their own weaknesses. Their shared failure to stand with Jesus in his hour of need. The betrayal of one of them. And the one that denied Jesus. And showed them where they all stood. Each one of them is weak, sinful human being. But more than that, Jesus' forgiveness of them, his understanding and acceptance of them, and his willingness to receive them in spite of their failures, and his promise to use them as his witnesses, had bonded them together into a great unity. The unity that is a symbol of what the Church of Jesus Christ is called to be. Does that speak to us, brothers and sisters? Can we relate to that? Does our church relate to this? Bonded together because of God's love to us, even when we are weak. We can still stand together because God loves us no matter what. Connected to God. And that's what the ascension of Jesus tells us. We are all connected to God in our baptism. We are made children of God. Jesus enters our hearts and lives and comes out in our words and deeds, and we are given a great commission, a great purpose for living, to share the caring love of Christ. As the Church of Jesus Christ, and we as a church here at Grace, we are called to welcome one another to forgive, to love, accept each other with the same forgiveness, love, and acceptance we have received from God. We are called to be those who speak of God's love to others, who bring family and friends to worship with us, who speak of God's love for Him. We focus this morning on the ascension of Jesus to remind us that we are connected to God. We are connected to God through faith in Christ Jesus, and like those first disciples, we have the same mission ahead of us. Jesus has ascended to God, the Father in heaven, no longer here with us, bodily present, but before He left, He gave us the same promise. God will fill us with His Spirit and send us forth as witnesses of His love. We are now the presence of Jesus Christ in the world. His word that is spoken and His love shared with others. This pandemic, if we think of it in a human side, looks like it's a barrier for us to connect and relate to the world. But no. It is not a reason for us to be disconnected, nor for us not to see each other. And I know we have not seen each other literally for a year now. And yet what put us together, standing tall in the midst of this storm, of this pandemic? Because Christ has pulled us together. And what is in the center of our being is Christ our Lord. Still, we are the body of Christ, and Christ is the head. And we are connected. Though He is no longer here with us, we know that the Holy Spirit will continue to lead us and empower us as we go to the world and bring the good news. May God bless us, anoint us, and empower us as we avail of God's love, be led and be used in the mighty name and power of our God. God bless us all. Amen. With that, brothers and sisters, with our connectedness with Christ, let us rise above the ordinary and share the blessings we have, gifts, tithes, pledges, anything we receive from God for the Lord's service, let us share. As we hear a special music from the Granadosan brothers.
I surrender
all to
What a powerful message of a song shared to us today. But before we go into our prayer of dedication, just a side note. As we all know, with the gift and talents of these Grand Dawson brothers, we are truly blessed. And this is one of those things that God is working as they serve through their gift. But one thing is that we've been praying for one of their brothers, Brother Charles Grant Dawson. We prayed for him last week, for he was in the hospital. And because of our prayers, with all those complications, I think he is just one of the rare person with that kind of a operation that it's really complicated. But then with our prayers, now he is back home. And praise God for that. And also, we have witnessed the Baluyot family, and you know, as they share continuously with their gifts and graces, one of their siblings, brother, I think Junior, in the Philippines, he was in the hospital, but because of their faith and because of our prayers together, because of our connectedness, he's now back home. So these are living testimonies of God's at work in our lives. So let's continue to be obedient, to be responding and willing as we serve the Lord through the gifts and graces God has given us. And for that, let us be in prayer. God of all creation, powerful Spirit, Savior of all, use our gifts to bring hope to a world that is in need of your grace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. For our closing song, let us sing this song, On Christ the Solid Rock I Stand. And as we sing this, I also at the same time post an invitation for you to be open to the Lord's leading. If you felt led to new ways God is leading you to in doing ministry, if you feel God's voice, if you hear God's voice nudging you at this time, and he needs your response in special ways, let this be the moment. And if you want to renew relationships to one another, and if you want to ask forgiveness, you want to accept the Lord Jesus Christ in your life, make this an opportunity to come to his presence and see how the Lord does his love and grace in your life. Let us sing this song. Oh,
is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand, all other ground is sinking sand. When darkness seems to hide his face, I rest on his unchanging grace. Every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand, all other ground is sinking sand. Covenant his blood, support me in the whelming flood. When all around my soul gives way, he then is all my hope and stay. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand, all other ground is sinking sand. Shall come with trumpet sound. Oh, may I then in him be found, dressed in his righteousness alone, faultless to stand before the throne. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand, all other ground sinking sand. On Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand, all other ground is sinking sand.
I'd like to take this moment for us to be in prayer. And I believe that Pastor Stan Cueto is here with us. And if Pastor Stan is available, would you mind giving us the closing prayer and also the benediction?
You're muted, Pastor.
Can you hear me now?
Yes. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, let's bow our heads in prayer. As we end this virtual worship, O Lord, we praise you and glorify you for allowing us to, in spite of what's going on, we can come and worship you. Let, O Lord, the message today remain in our hearts and let it live in us, so that as we go into the world, may your goodness and love be known by people. Let, O Lord, love prevail over hate, and let peace over trouble. Eternal and loving God, dismiss us with your blessing. Give us your assurance that whatever come and whatever may your goodwill be always be done. In the name of the Lord who sent us into the world, bless us, keep us, and preserve us with his goodness and love. And may the love of God be with you now and evermore. Amen. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious upon you. And may the love of God and peace that passes all understanding be yours forever, now and evermore. Amen.
Blessed be the tie that binds our hearts in Christian love, the fellowship of kindred minds is like to that above. Before our God we come and pour our ardent prayers, our fears, our hopes, our aims are one, our comforts and our cares. We share
Before we pass the peace of Christ with each other, just again, a little reminder about what I asked earlier about our reopening. If you are in favor of opening and be back to church, please respond with yes and or no. And you can do that in our chat. Feature in our Zoom, and I hope and pray that we'll have the Spirit leading us for our responses, and hope it will be something that will say I'm in favor. But anyway, let's pass the peace of Christ with each other.
Oh, peace, everybody.
Peace, everyone.
Peace.
Okay. Peace be with you.
Peace be with you.
Have a good day.
Hello, peace be with you all. Thank
hello,
you.
Hello, everyone.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning. Peace, everyone.
Good morning. Peace, everyone.
I love you. I love you.
Peace.
How do I do the chat?
I'm in favor of it.
Who's in favor?
My Susan.
Say yes or no. Yes or
I
no.
Did.
Your vote.
That's the thing. Okay. I said yes, but I just pushed.
Yes.
Okay, Manang Yunus says yes. How about Ate Nita?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, the markers, yes. Ate Joe.
Bye.
Bye.
Good
to see you, Ate Lucy.
Bye, Ate Lucy.
Yes.
Atenita.
See you all.
Yes.
Hi, Lucy.
Yes.
Oh, I love you with the love of the Lord.
Yeah, Atenita. One of the words. I love you with the love of the Lord.
Okay, answer. Answer.
We're
going back.
Lucy. Okay. So, So Ati Chading, yes for opening. Ati Nita, yes for opening. Auntie Luz, yes.
Liz, very
Marker
good.
Baluyot, yes. My dad, maybe. Not yet. How about Ati Lucy?
Yes, yes,
all the time.
Pastor June, yes. Ati Joe?
Yes.
Are you interested in coming in person?
Yes. Sister Odelia says yes.
I told you, you did answer me.
And Vanjie says yes.
I guess I'm the only one that's a no.
Who is a no?
Me, Lillian. Yes.
You're the only one that says no?
Yeah, I'm not.
Okay,
I don't
we
feel
understand.
Comfortable.
This is a democracy. It's okay.
I feel more comfortable doing this.
Okay.
No.
Just remember when we open, there's no singing, there's no chanting,
right?
No fellowship afterwards.
Great.
Go in and you go out. And there, right now, there's no singing allowed.
It to everyone.
That's very important to remember.
Yes. You have to wear your mask on at all times.
Okay.
About the vaccine.
No hugging, no
shaking of hands.
Oh, yeah, no shaking. Okay.
No touching.
Vaccination.
No elbows.
Like
no, but we get to see if we're all alive, right?
But I think it will still be on virtual though.
Yeah, it'll be on virtual.
Bye-bye.
So we still have that option.
Goodbye.
Have a good day, everyone. Good to see you all.
Okay, God bless everybody. There it is.
Ingat po kayong lahat.
I love you with the love of the Lord. Oh, I love you with the love of
oh,
the
my
Lord.
Goodness.
Okay. God bless everybody. I'm going to touch something. I'm going to touch something, and you'll all disappear, or I will disappear.
I love you with the love of the Lord.
I'm calling your mama.
Lucy.
Bye-bye.